What's up, fighting fans? Tibz from the Fight IQ channel. Today we're coming back for another episode of the Fight IQ show. Man, we got some good fights last weekend. Let me know in the comments which was your favorite performance. Now it's about to get hot in here with our weekend preview. A lot of events with a lot of high-level matchup. It was hard, but I picked three fights that will deliver your weekly dose of adrenaline and that you shouldn't miss. After that, I'll also recap what will happen in the combat sports world this weekend. So let's get ready to rumble! On my menu, there will be the PFL 7 in Nashville on Friday 2nd, the One Fight Night 24 in Bangkok, Thailand on Friday 2nd, the UFC Fight Night in Abu Dhabi on Saturday 3rd, and the Crawford vs. Madrimov boxing event in Los Angeles on Saturday 3rd. Number 3, I picked Dakota Dicheva vs. Jenna Bishop. It will be at the PFL 7 in Nashville on Friday 2nd, and is for the women's flyweights playoffs. I'm so hyped up for that matchup. Two of the best women's flyweights in the world facing each other for a spot in the PFL finals and an opportunity to get that $1 million paycheck. It's two different fighting style and two different career paths colliding. Dakota Dangerous Dicheva, 26 years old, 12-0, 10 wins by way of knockout. She's an extremely talented striker, showing a lot of maturity in her game, fighting with a high level of skills, and being a pro for only 3 years. After winning her first three pro fights by KO or TKO on the British scene, she had to test herself elsewhere. First in Canada versus the experienced Simone da Silva, 8-3 at the time, who she stopped in the second round in January of 2022, and then versus the undefeated Paola Cristina, 5-0 at the time, who she beat via unanimous decision, the only time in her career she went to the judges, in Abu Dhabi during UAE Warriors 28 in March of 2022. PFL couldn't let this prospect go elsewhere and gave her a contract. She made her debut in August of 2022 versus Hasna Gaber, knocking her out under a minute. After another win with another finish 3 months later, PFL decided to make her compete on the PFL Europe Flyweights Tournament for the 2023 season. She confirmed all her promises, dominating the season with 3 wins with 3 finishes, including a doctor stoppage versus Valentina Tibz in the finals last December. With the PFL Europe 2023 flyweight title and a $100,000 paycheck, she went to the big league for the 2024 season. She won her 2 regular season fights by TKO in the first round, versus Lisa Moldin in April and versus Chelsea Hackett in June. Now she's only 1 fight away from the finals and she will face her toughest opponent to that day. Jenna Bishop, 38 years old, 7-1, 4 wins by way of submission. One of the most gifted grappler in women's MMA, BJJ Black Belt, won a whole lot of titles in BJJ and grappling, like the IBJJF World Masters Championship in 2017, before transitioning fully to MMA in 2021. She started at LFA, where she fought 4 times in 2 years, getting 2 finishes via rear naked choke, and getting 2 decision wins over the tough Dayoni Barboza and Luana Santos. She got the attention of Bellator, where she made her debut in February of 2023, beating Elina Kalionidou by unanimous decision. At Bellator 300, last October, she won versus Ilara Johan with an armbar in the first round. It was enough for the new management to put her in the PFL Flyweights tournament for the 2024 season. She won her first fight, again with an armbar in round 1, versus Chelsea Hackett in April, but got handed her first professional loss by split decision in a really close fight versus the former UFC title contender Tayla Santos last June. She still earned enough points to be part of the playoff and is determined to reach the finals. That's a really clear striker versus grappler matchup. Even though Dicheva is working on her BJJ and Bishop on her striking, the keys will be distance management and pace. If Dicheva can stay at striking distance, using a long reach and dictating the pace, she will finish Bishop. I am heading toward that scenario. I don't think Bishop will be able to get close to Dicheva and take her down before taking a lot of damage. So I predict a 3rd round KO for Dicheva, because it will take time to put Bishop out while staying at a comfortable range. Number 2, Corey Sandhagen versus Umar Nurmagomedov, main event of the UFC Fight Night in Abu Dhabi on Saturday 3rd. A bantamweight clash that can reshape the whole division. It's the number 2 facing the number 10, so one has more to lose than the other. Corey Sandhagen, 32 years old, 17-4, 10 finishes. The Sandman is the one that ranked number 2. He joined the UFC in 2018 as a featherweight, but after his first fight, a win by TKO over Austin Arnett, he moved down to bantamweight, starting his ascension to the top of this division. 4 fights win streak between August of 2018 and August of 2019, finishing Yuri Alcantara, Mario Bautista, and getting the decision versus John Lineker and Rafael Assunção. He then collided with another up-and-comer, Aljamain Sterling, in June of 2020. He lost via rear naked choke in the first round, getting his first loss inside the UFC. He still stayed at the top of the division, beating Marlon Moraes and Frankie Edgar with memorable knockouts. The end of 2021 was difficult for him, fighting for the number 1 contender spot versus TJ Dillashaw in July and losing via split decision, and then facing Petr Yan in October, losing by unanimous decision. He took his time to come back, but since then, 3 fights, 3 great performances, doctor stoppage after 4 rounds versus Song Yeodong in September of 2022, split decision win versus Chito Vera in March of 2023, and he dominated Rob Font during 5 rounds in August of 2023 to get the unanimous decision. He should have actually faced Umar Nurmagomedov instead of Font, but the Russian had to withdraw. And they will now finally meet. Umar Nurmagomedov, 28 years old, 17-0, 9 finishes. Impressive record for the Dagestani, built on his amazing grappling skills and an efficient striking. He became pro in 2016 at the age of 20. In less than 3 years, he piled up 10 wins on the Russian scene and also a fight in the prelims of PFL. After 2 other wins in 2019 at GFC 20 and PFL 6, he caught the eye of the UFC. He was supposed to fight in 2020, but due to COVID, his 3 fights were cancelled. Finally made his debut in January of 2021, submitting Sergei Morozov in the second round. A year later, in March of 2022, he submitted Brian Keller in the first round. Naturally, he faced some tougher opposition after that. Nate Maness, who he beat via unanimous decision in June of 2022, and then Raoni Barcelos, who he knocked out in the first round in January of 2023. We last saw him in action in March, facing the newcomer Behzad Almahan and defeating him via unanimous decision. He is now looking at an opportunity to propulse himself at the top of this division by facing his toughest test to date. Indeed, Umar's record is impressive, but he never faced the contenders that Sandhagen faced. Still, it's hard to match Umar against other fighters that prove that he's feared in the division. I think it will be a back and forth fight, really close, and I expect it to go to the decision. We're gonna see some great striking, but also technical grappling. I think it's really bold from Sandhagen to put his number 2 on the line against somebody 8 ranks below him with a scary record. And I think he will shock the MMA world by winning that fight in 5 rounds, showing that it's still at the top of the division for a reason. He might even be the next one in line for a title shot after the O'Malley vs. Merab fight. And number 1, Terence Crawford vs. Israel Madrimov, main event of the boxing card with the same name in Los Angeles on Saturday 3rd. It's for the WBA World Super Welterweight title and the WBO Interim World Super Welterweight title. The most exciting fight of the week and potential fight of the year candidate. One of the most skilled active boxer versus a wild power puncher coming up strong. Terence Bud Crawford, 36 years old, 40-0, 31 wins by way of knockout. He's a southpaw but comfortable in orthodox as well. Pro since 2008, he started as a lightweight and progressively moved up to welterweight, accumulating belts, wins and knockouts. Thanks to his highly technical striking, his footwork, his powerful and accurate counters, he defeated the best from every weight class. At lightweight, Ricky Burns, Yuriokis Gamboa, Raimundo Beltran. At super lightweight, Thomas Dulorme, Victor Postol, Felix Diaz. At welterweight, Jeff Horn, Jose Benavides Jr., Amir Khan, Cal Brook, Sean Porter, David Avanesyan. And in his last fight, Errol Spence Jr., where he became undisputed champion of the welterweight division, that means he had the 4 belts, in July of 2023. After getting the WBO World Lightweight title, being undisputed in super lightweight and welterweight, he is now looking to get a title in the super welterweight division. But it won't be easy, as his opponent has some real power. Israel the Dream Madrimov, 29 years old, 10-0-1, 7 wins by way of knockouts. Pro since 2018, he has an impressive amateur resume, over 350 bouts, gold medal at the Asian Championships in 2017 and at the Asian Games in 2018. He also participated in the World Series of Boxing. This incredible experience gave him a lot of legitimacy, allowing him to compete for the WBA Intercontinental Super Welterweight title for his second pro fight in March of 2019. He faced Frank Rojas and destroyed him in only 2 rounds. Thanks to his aggressive style, his devastating power punches, his spectacular leaping shots, and his very effective footwork, he kept climbing the ladder of the super welterweight division. He beat, for example, Eric Walker, Emmanuel Colombo, and Michel Soto, who he knocked out in round 9. Those wins got him an opportunity to compete for the vacant WBA World Super Welterweight title. It was last March in Riyadh for what was Madrimov's last but also most impressive performance. He defeated Magomed Gurbanov, 25-0 at the time, by TKO in the 5th round after smothering and overpowering his opponent. He is now facing the biggest challenge of his young professional career for his first title defense. It's an interesting matchup, big risks for both guys, even though Crawford has more to lose in my opinion. I believe that Madrimov will have the power advantage as he is a natural in this weight class. He has also a beautiful way to find angles, but Crawford is even better at that game and will definitely be faster. Also, his huge experience will be a factor. He faced some of the best boxers on earth at their best and came out victorious. His confidence in his own abilities might also play a mental trick on Madrimov, who despite his huge amateur career has only 11 pro fights and one world title fight. I expect Madrimov to be more cautious than usual because of this, and that will be a problem. Bud will take advantage of that and make Madrimov doubt, making him pay every time he misses a shot. I'm even predicting a KO in the later rounds from Crawford, who will become champion in a 4th different weight class. I'm not underestimating Madrimov though, who has a great future if he continues evolving, but he's still a little bit green. There are some other fights that I want to keep an eye on. At PFL, there is Tyler Santos vs. Liz Carmouche in the other flyweight semi-final. Two really experienced athletes, but I do think Santos will get that one. She seems a bit above the rest of the PFL roster, and she's actually my favorite for the title this season. The rest of the card doesn't attract me that much, the heavyweight tournament is not really exciting this season, and prelims fights are not intriguing. One Fight Night has some really good fights, but there is one in particular I don't want to miss. The main event, Jarrod Brooks vs. Gustavo Ballard for the interim MMA strawweight title, is gonna be a banger. The rest of the card is filled with a lot of promising Muay Thai and MMA fights, so don't blink. The card of the UFC Fight Night is pretty good, especially the main card, Alvarez vs. Brenner to open it. Interesting matchup at lightweight. Dern vs. Godinez at strawweight looks like a last chance for Mackenzie Dern, who lost 3 of the last 4, while Godinez is on the rise, despite losing a last fight versus the future title contender, Verna Jandiroba. Ferguson vs. Chiesa at 170, probably a farewell to those two OGs who want to go out on a win. Chito Vera vs. Figueiredo at bantamweight, a real banger. Chito wants to stay at the top of the division, while Figueiredo wants a title shot as soon as possible. This one might steal the show. As co-main, we have the new prospect Sharamagomedov facing Oleksiy Chuk at middleweight. I'm surprised to see the Polish fighter so soon after his loss to Kevin Holland due to a terrible armbar. He might not be 100%. Also, he stays on 2 losses in a row and said that he might be done with the sport if he loses that one. Not a good signal. I think Shara will finish him and keep the hype going. The Crawford vs. Madrimov boxing event will be full of good and even great fights. Jared Anderson, the real big baby, the number one American heavyweight, will have the biggest test of his undefeated pro career, facing Martin Bakule, former IBO Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion. We have the Cuban prodigy Andy Cruz, who will defend his IBF International Lightweight title versus Antonio Moran. David Morrell will face Radivoje Kalajdzic for his first fight at light heavyweight and for the vacant WBA World Light Heavyweight title. Andy Ruiz Jr. vs. Jarrell Miller at heavyweight. To be honest, I think this one is really unbalanced and that Andy Ruiz will get that one easily. And finally, as a co-main event, we have Isaac Pitbull Cruz for his first title defense versus Jose Valenzuela. I also expect Pitbull to get rid of his opponent without too much trouble. And if you like looking out for prospects, keep an eye on Fury FC 95, Lux Fight League 44, and LFA 189, all on Friday and all available on the UFC Fight Pass. And we're done here, now you know what to watch this weekend, guys. As usual, punch those like and subscribe buttons, it helps me a lot. Also, I want to see you guys in the comments, on Discord, on Instagram, on Telegram, to give me your thoughts and your picks about the coming matchups. Enjoy the fights, I'll see you next week. 99 bombs and I'm still capped at 100, yeah. It's been a long time coming, they ain't covering my cloth, they tugging. Putting up numbers, 99 bombs and I'm still capped at 100, yeah.